the film you're about to watch is an initiative of Sutherland Shire Council. During and following the pandemic, it was clear that older and younger members of our community were experiencing loneliness. With the Sutherland Shire having one of the highest ageing populations in Sydney, we want to create an opportunity for meaningful connections and communications between these two generations. Through this pilot program, we aim to reduce loneliness by sharing knowledge and experience, which results in a better understanding between the two generations. We believe that this program delivered all that and more, and we hope that it will pave the way for schools and aged care homes, along with the wider community, to continue along this path. Sutherland Shire Council is proud of this initiative, and we all know that you will enjoy watching this journey.
At a time when our society has become more fragmented, when more of us suffer from social isolation than ever before, you're about to see a film that I'm sure will inspire you to think about the many ways we can all help rebuild social cohesion in the place where we live. From time to time, we just need to remind ourselves that we humans belong to a social species, a cooperative species. We're hopeless in isolation. We need each other. We need families, neighborhoods, friends, workplaces, groups and communities of all kinds to nurture us and sustain us and to give us that all-important sense of belonging that is so fundamental to our mental and emotional health. Kindness is like the lubricant that keeps the machinery of connection, engagement, and community working. Kindness, to me, is the purest form of human love because it doesn't depend on us liking each other or agreeing with each other or even knowing each other. It's just a natural part of being human. The film you're about to see has kindness at its heart. It shows the power that intergenerational connection can have in our community and the ripple effect it can create. It shows how our common humanity is far more important than any of the differences between us, whether they're related to age, gender, ethnicity, or any other aspect of our personal identity. So sit back and enjoy watching the interactions between two generations you might not have expected to have so much fun together or to hit it off so well. And then try to imagine what you might do to help build social harmony in your own neighbourhood.
Hands up if you're a cat person. And hands up if you're a dog person. I like that. That's what makes the world go round. You know?
Know that we have the themes just to give you some ideas of what to talk about, but that's just to help lead on to these other conversations.
Over the course of the next 8 weeks, students from the local Sylvania High School in the Sutherland Shire will come to visit residents at Hammond Care in Miranda to take part in a trial program designed to bring the generations together, encourage connection and improve the well-being and mental health of the participants. Sutherland Shire has one of the highest ageing populations in New South Wales. And with the social isolation that resulted from the pandemic lockdowns, community leaders at Sutherland Shire Council feel now is the time to try and redress some of the negative effects that both young and older people have faced. Council engaged Sam to lead the sessions, where this cohort of residents are all experiencing some level of dementia. She used her background in psychology and facilitating intergenerational programs to adapt the activities for this trial.
One thing that you might have learned about Beatrice over here might make a connection with Peter or Maddie over here. And this is the wonderful thing. It's almost like a jigsaw puzzle where we start to put all these pieces together and realise that we're all so connected.
For residents and students, the initial conversations can be a little awkward at times.
Well, beautiful day, clear day, isn't it? Nice breeze. Right there, dear?
Yep.
Get on, yeah. I'll buy you a beer next week.
The key to running a program such as this is knowing when to step back and let people actually interact and interact as they may normally in life. So we don't want to over-engineer it.
Do you sing? Do you sing?
Yeah.
I sing. Especially when I've got a needle in my back, so. No, I used to sing. Before I was married. It wasn't so much rock and roll then, but still good, see, good music.
I heard you liked tap dancing.
Abby?
Tap dancing.
Oh, I used to. Let's dance with some nice girls.
People living with dementia, they can still enjoy life and have fun, and they can do a lot of things that any other older person would do. They just live in the moment. You don't need the memory for that. You just need that relationship, that connection, holding hands, seeing other people smiling, and they will respond to that.
We often feel in society that we are hiding our older people away a little, and they have so much value, they have so much still to contribute to all of our lives, to our community, and in particular to younger people's lives. I think when it comes to dementia as well, it's not easy, it's very complex. There's no single definition or no two people present in the same way, and they can be really different from week to week.
A program like this wouldn't be possible without the consent and support of family and loved ones.
This is about my wife, Kay. Kay was an avid reader and could get through 4 or 5 books at the one time and read that many every week without fail for years and years and years. Sadly, can't read anymore. That's what sometimes dementia does to you.
Hopefully they'll learn a little bit from us. We've got a few things to teach them, as much as they've got to teach us, because there are so many gaps in our knowledge these days, because we're left behind. You're left behind as well, yeah. It's a learning curve.
This is where we're going to be living.
This is where we do live, though. You've lived here for 12 months now.
Oh, I don't recognise this place.
Oh, well, it takes a while. Yeah, don't worry about it.
Oh, I honestly don't know.
There's over 100 types of dementia. The most common is Alzheimer's disease, and some of these residents have Alzheimer's disease. The short-term memory is impaired, usually in early stages of the condition, but they remain able to remember events of the past. Other things could be difficulties with communication and language, forgetting what to say, finding the right word.
They have so much to tell. When you ask Mum about her past, it's all there. Like, it's all there. She remembers everything about her parents, about where she used to live. She talks to my kids and she gives them advice. sometimes she's a bit naughty, and the other way she does. That's part of dementia as well. She'll, you know, tell them things. I'm going, Mum, don't encourage them. You know, oh, go and drink with your friends. It's fun, you know.
Dementia is difficult, especially for young kids or anyone to try and deal with the symptoms. So you really need to understand, you know, what the symptoms are so you can have that better interaction.
When I was younger, I had that much memories. But now, as I get older, I can't remember things that I did early in life.
Is it frustrating?
Oh, yeah, of course it is. Mm.
There's no medication that can cure dementia. We want to delay the progression of the dementia, and we do it through relationships with physical activity, with social activity, stimulation of all their abilities.
Using SAM's program of activities, the students will get the opportunity to learn from the residents and practice their communication skills in a safe space where mistakes are quickly forgotten.
Who were you talking with today? Who was sitting next to you today? Do you know? Do you remember the girl's name?
I do get cold, yes.
And did you guys have a good conversation today? Can you recall what you talked about or anything you mentioned?
We had some things, yeah.
So we were talking about the Olympics, and he was asking me what sports I like, and I told him soccer and running, and he said, doesn't matter if anyone thinks that it's not girly, you should always do what makes you happy. It was very special to hear.
You told her, don't listen to anyone else. If you get your mind set on something, you can do it. You'll be able to achieve anything you want.
Yes, who said that? Me? I will. Yes, I'll accept that.
And what are you learning from this experience?
How to be more understanding and how to be more patient, and just how, if you really like talk to someone, how much like someone can appreciate it. And it's like all the little things that matter.
Kindness, empathy, understanding each other's perspectives, being okay to listen without judgment, even if you have a different perspective to someone else. You know, these are key values that we need to create a better society, and we need our children, our teenagers, our young adults to develop this. And we also need some of our older adults to hear it and to, you know, develop it by talking to the younger generation.
When you're going through life and you've got older, you've got a bit of wisdom because you've gone through life. But some young people, when they first come to meet old people, they think they know everything, but they don't. They've got to learn through life.
Everyone was like, nervous, like, and curious, like, what could this be?
It wasn't that scary to talk to everybody. It was definitely more of a learning experience.
It was more like the fear of the unknown.
Yeah.
Like, we had no idea what to expect.
You'll have lots of joy in life. And if anybody gives you any trouble,
when it was been raised to me, this project, I totally agreed on it and really happy to support. I'm pretty sure all the high school students will get a lot of wisdom from our residents.
This is our second time coming to Hammond Care. Well, I've been talking mostly with Graham and Dennis. Graham is, he's a character. He likes to tell lots of jokes, and it's very fun to be around.
You think he's serious, and then all of a sudden he'll laugh, or he'll say, oh, what's that on your hand? And you say, oh, and he'll get it up and he'll go, show me, and then he'll kiss it. How many kids have you had?
Me?
Yeah, how many kids have you got?
Four.
That's right.
No, how many goats are kids?
Growing up, it was the usual warnings that you give your teenage daughters and everything like that, and I can't say that I really listened to them, but I wish I had it.
Are you a pianist? You are a very good pianist. You might play for us some piano.
I might.
Yeah, we might invite you for a concert.
How important is music in your life?
I enjoy it if I can play it well. And if I can't play it well, the enjoyment's not so good.
It's been really good talking with Peter this week about all his favourite things, and I saw that it said he spoke French, so we were talking about how I travelled to France, and I think he did too.
First week I think we all felt a little bit awkward and didn't really know how to communicate, and everyone was kind of going off the script really heavily, but I think in particular I know Olivia and Rebecca have been two that have opened up a lot more and really practicing their communication skills and feeling a bit more comfortable in the unknown.
Does age matter in friendship?
No. No way.
Yeah, you can build friendships with like someone that's like any age. They don't need to be your age. Like, it's just good to have that variety too, to like not just talk to like the same age group all the time, because like if you're speaking to someone older than you, you're hearing new experiences and different things that happen that we didn't know about or have happened to like any of us.
Shoes are a little bit like friendship. They're stiff at first, but once you wear them in, they get very comfortable. Kay's very like nice to talk to. She's very talkative, so it's always always easy to start up a conversation.
That's a secret.
I really like the kids. They're so wonderfully good. And keep it up, kids. You're doing wonders.
Don't think that your life is ordinary. What you're doing is extraordinary.
I spoke to Nina. She was so
fun.
Cute.
She was so nice.
She's Maltese.
You have to want to put in the effort.
You can't
be
get
patient.
Forced into it, or you're not.
Yeah, you have to like
it.
Genuinely want to be part of it and get
and, like,
to know
talk
them.
To everyone. Yeah,
yes.
It's more genuine and more one-on when you're doing it in person rather than, let's say, on the phone or on a FaceTime call. It's definitely, it feels more special.
It's really what we're doing at the end of the day is connecting people, and that's the power of friendship and love.
What do you think about love, Kay?
Love.
Love.
There's always love. There's always someone's got love or not love. And there's always someone really mean, hating the one they loved instead of forgetting them and going on with their lives and just over the top. So at the end, you're going to say, hey, love, shut up. I'm sick of hearing it. Go home, have a little glass of wine, and don't feel guilty. Just have it and you'll feel much better. Only one.
I felt like at the start I was afraid because I didn't know what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. But then, because at the start we didn't do that much chatting, we just sat there in silence for a bit.
Yeah.
But then through it all, we started to get to know everyone and everyone built their confidence, and then we all just started to chat and have a wonderful time.
Yeah.
Because we got to know everyone, it opened up more conversations.
Yeah.
It opened up more like abilities to relate to each other, and it was just a better feeling once we had gotten that first one out of the way. It was like, it was easier because Sam like provided all those conversation starters.
Yeah.
There was always like endless things to fill the time, which always made it like less intimidating.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The program focuses on a different topic and uses props or activities to generate conversation and encourage a deeper connection.
Yeah. So, high five.
I think one of the key learnings in working with people who are experiencing dementia is really trying to find those activities that can really be done and enjoyed in the moment. And so today on the way out, we got some frisbees and some really colourful balls, and we put some cones down and we had a competition. Everyone loves a competition. It doesn't matter if you're young or old. You need to be able to try and find those things that bring people into happiness in that moment.
These are therapist cards. They've got like some cute animal pictures on it with some quotes. You're not gonna succeed at everything you try. And that's okay.
That's okay, thank you.
And today we had a really fun session where we were matching proverbs, you know, wise old sayings and adages, advice in life. It's a really nice way to do something fun, have a little bit of competition between, you know, the three different groups, but also have it engaging where it's something that they could then look at the different proverbs and talk about, you know, the meaning behind it.
Does that make sense? Blood is thicker, is golden.
No.
I like the expression, the journey of 1,000 miles sounds really exotic. Begins with a single step. That's all it takes.
Yeah.
It's easy.
What was it like growing up for you?
Growing up?
Yeah, like how was your school life?
Oh, full of fun and mischief.
Yeah. Did you have any dreams when you were younger? What you wanted to do?
Oh, I'd like to say I did, but I can't remember that much. Do you?
I do have a few.
Go on.
I want to get into art.
Yeah, it's very popular now.
Yeah.
Girls do dressmaking, I didn't. I didn't like things like that. Yeah. A lot of women do. Yeah.
You know, the feedback I get from the students, they're often quite surprised when they get to the end at how much they got out of it. I, you know, hear that they increase their confidence. You know, they feel more confident going back and talking at school with other kids and to say yes to other activities.
I think one of the reasons I did it was definitely to build my confidence and to get better at talking to people, especially new people.
Really, they're going to need it throughout their life. It doesn't really matter what industry you go into, just those basic sort of social skills, being able to kind of step out of your comfort zone, talk to people from a different walk of life than yourself, being able to make connection where you wouldn't necessarily think there is a natural connection there, but we're learning, I guess, we have a lot more in common than we have different.
That one. All right, we're doing this one.
Do you think loneliness can be a problem for both younger and older people?
Yes.
Always.
No hesitation. Mm-hmm. I think it can be more prominently seen in older people because when you're younger, you always have school, you're always going to be surrounded by your family.
Yeah.
But when you're older and you're in a nursing home, you might not always be able to get visits. The people around you might be strangers to you, especially if you have dementia. I reckon it's definitely possible for both.
I feel like loneliness in younger people isn't really talked about or heard of as much as it is in the older generation. Younger people, they talk to each other mostly online, and so you're not really talking face to face as much. And I feel like that can affect them because they're not having that connection.
Music plays a special role in this intergenerational program. It's been shown to boost brain activity for people living with dementia, helping them to recall memories and improve cognitive and behavioural symptoms of the disease. It's increasingly being used as a therapeutic tool and helps the residents with their sense of identity and social connectedness.
It's so powerful. You see it here on a daily basis. We've got high care cottages with high care residents and they don't speak. You put music on or a familiar song and you can see it in their face. They recognise that song, and some even sing the words. So they can't speak normally, and then all of a sudden their favourite song from years ago comes on. It's like they don't have dementia. It's incredible. Dennis, he's quite musical, as you know, loves playing the piano, and he too is really, you know, coming along in a program like this. He sort of keeps to himself, very friendly and polite, but seeing him in this sort of atmosphere engaging with these kids, he's just a lot more social.
Playing music is very important for him, and it's quite interesting and important that he's still able to play and that he has that opportunity to play.
The one that I call my little magic moment was when Olivia was brave enough to bring her flute along, and Dennis, who is a pianist, was sitting there, and I could really see as she was playing, he just became more and more alive, and then he started clapping. And at the end, he said something along the lines of, "That's the most beautiful thing I've ever heard." And so it was just very, very special. Yeah.
We've got some questions about what music means in our life and what kind of music we like, and maybe some concerts we've been to or we're going to.
Mum loves music. If she could be partying 24 hours a day, she would be. You know, we'll dance, we'll do the chicken dance, anything.
The residents and the kids, it's just lovely to see them so engaged, even though they're years apart. And even at the office people, they're like, "What's going on down there?" They can hear the music, the noise, the laughs, and you know, everyone comes down for a bit of a sticky beak.
One of the lovely things was actually put in one of the cards that Kira wrote to Nina, which Nina had said to her, was just live in the moment and be in the moment. And really there's no one who's more in the moment than our people who are experiencing dementia.
It's not really hard, but you just have to reintroduce yourself and remind them that who you are and why you're here and what you're doing. Like, interact with them in a way that will help them, make them feel better about the situation.
This week, Sam has enlisted the help of yoga teacher Rachel to guide the group through a movement and mindfulness session. Evidence suggests that less than 20% of people over 65 engage in an adequate level of physical activity. Yet gentle exercise can lead to greatly improved health outcomes, including better mental health, gains in strength and balance, and a reduced risk of many diseases.
What I like to describe yoga is it's getting the mind and the body connected so they're at the same speed. And it's a curiosity, it's an exploration of your body. It doesn't matter the shape or the form, it's how it feels. And getting rid of superficial tension as well. I teach teenagers in high schools. They are amazed at what their body-mind connection feels like.
Can we lift up one knee and maybe hold it? So you can feel a lot of energy going through your body, that the muscles are all charged at the same time.
They were all really encouraged by each other. The teenagers are more adventurous, of course, and don't feel they have any limitations and just go for it. And I think that encouraged the seniors to give it a try.
That's it. Well done.
It's really important that we take into account that our teenagers are in a very fast-paced, you know, instant gratification world. And we had, you know, a couple of the students say, "That was my favourite session, doing a few peaceful yoga moves." Their lives are very full, and we're trying to help slow that down.
With Jeanette, she mentioned to me, I said, "Have you ever done yoga before?" And her eyes lit up. She goes, "Yes, I'm a yoga teacher." I said, "How about you tell me how to demonstrate it and I'll do it for you."
Quality of life is different for everyone. One of the things is to keeping their mobility and their physical activity. Just the fact that they come out of their home and walk here, and sometimes they do physical activities here, like throwing the ball today or the yoga, because it gives us a lot of the feeling of competence when we are still able to mobilize and walk freely.
Our community is aging. People are living longer and longer. We are in a way depending on young people, and for them to help, they need to understand older people and especially people with dementia. Mama, quiero que sepas que te agradezco por todo lo que has hecho en mi vida. No hay nadie en el mundo que yo le agradezca más. I want mom to know that I'm going to be here for her forever, that I will not leave her alone ever, and whenever she needs me, I'll be here. I live 5 minutes away. Te amo. Beso. I got a bit teary now. But yeah.
In the final week of the program, the residents and students are joined by family members in a tribute session to their newfound friends. Sons, daughters, mothers and fathers come together with their loved ones to show appreciation for the time shared.
This is a really important session. It's where we pay our respects and we reflect on time together.
What a wonderful initiative. When all our young people come together with our more mature people. Now, you young ones, you have so much information, so much history here to listen to some of these incredible stories.
But a massive thank you to all you students. I know how intimidating, nerve-wracking, let's be honest, awkward it can be at certain times to have conversations with a different generation. But just wanting to encourage you to keep the conversations going, not just after this program wraps up, but in your community, when you see someone at the shops, just feel empowered and confident to strike a conversation, hi, how are you going? Because to feel heard, to feel valued, to feel listened to means more to them and us as a family than I can ever explain.
Just a massive, massive thank you, and to Sam for being so communicative. Every week we've had a download. I felt so connected to the program and invested, and my brother and I just can't say thank you enough for that.
Well, thank you.
One of my favorite memories from this program was when our students danced to Not Much by Tina Turner, because we found out that you were a fan of her.
I love talking about music and getting to know things that you like. I really liked when you played piano for the students.
Dear Ted, throughout this program, I've gotten to know you so well. I'm so grateful to have been able to get to know you, and I'm happy to have created that lovely bond with you. You are a lovely person to talk to. You are so funny, kind, and beautiful. You have made my week to the last few weeks, Kay, and I hope you have enjoyed having me around.
I'm very proud to have been part of this. I must admit, to start with, I had some trepidations about whether it was going to work or it wasn't going to work. Isn't it nice to know that our world is going to get better? Later in the day.
It was definitely an emotional experience last week, like, because it's finally come to an end.
Mm-hmm.
I think we were all, like, deep down emotional too. You just had to put on a face.
I think a surprise for me was that on the last week before I left, Graham called me by my name,
mm-hmm,
and said, thank you for being with me, which really felt special to me.
Yeah.
You're great, bro. Did you get to talk?
You kept on building up my confidence by telling me heaps of amazing things.
Building up this.
My confidence.
Oh, confidence.
Yeah, you kept on building up.
You'll go plenty strong, mate. You'll go plenty strong. Just remember that you were down there having a cup of tea with a good bloke.
By the end of it, I could have like a conversation, have a joke, like a laugh. And I feel like we were like friends and like connected.
Towards the end, it was just like very familiar.
Yeah.
Mm. And it felt normal going there.
I feel like we've all gained a high level of maturity. I think we've all got a better understanding of everyone else beside ourselves after this program.
we all learnt to now not take anything for granted.
Yes.
Like, always be grateful for what you have, for the people that you have in your life, and for everything that makes you happy.
They just love the journey that they go on, even if it is a bit hard and difficult at the start. And you see them kind of like the transformation of the butterfly, really, the metamorphosis of going into the messy chrysalis and coming out slightly transformed, you know.
Everyone sooner or later will have some sort of relation with aged care. And I think this is an important aspect, is for students to have the experience of being in aged care and not having that stigma that older people are not able to do much, and for people living with dementia that they will forget what they are doing, so it doesn't matter. It matters.
Seeing them on the last week interact with all of their family, it's like something important to surround yourself with lots of people you can know and like grow up with, and that will stick with you later in life.
I think the family is like an anchor for them, mm-hmm. to like hold on to something. It gives them, they can always reflect back on family vacations, family meals, family celebrations,
yeah.
and it
yeah.
always helps them like stay with themselves.
It's time to say goodbye for now. But Sam and the staff hope this program will be just the beginning of more intergenerational connection.
Even before going to bed, what is on my mind is, how can I improve the life of the resident? Give a smile on their face, you know, and to for them to have a quality life every day. Young people, they might have the passion to look after the resident the same way that we have. That's why we're in this industry.
Overall, all of the students have shown that they had a really powerful experience. They're incredible young people who volunteer their time to be part of this program, and credit to them that they want to be involved, but they also understand the importance of giving back to others.
It's not easy. We need a lot of commitment from both organizations to make this happen. I think we are in a stage of reflection and trying to understand how can we implement this, what are the next steps. We are keen on continuing these opportunities.
I'd love to keep this going all the time, not just a 6 to 8 week program. And I think there's so many other residents we have that would benefit this, and so many other kids from high schools, you know, that would too.
When we did the Proverbs matching week, you know, one of them was all good things must come to an end. And I guess when there is ends in life, there are new beginnings. So, you know, I hope that people take away the importance of friendship, the importance of community. One of the things that I know is taken away is just that common humanity. We are so alike, and you need for older people and younger people to spend that time together to actually come to that realization.
I just want to say thank you to Nina, to always telling me to be confident and to always not be afraid to be who I am, and to always love myself and to always be appreciative of what I have. I'm really grateful for that. Love you, Nina.
Okay. Massive thank you. Thank you for giving me a new perspective, a new way of seeing life. And I hope you continue to bring humour to dark times in life, like you told me.
Mwah! I'll say thank you to Peter. And I think you're so full of wisdom, and you always had something really interesting to say. And I just hope that you'll hopefully remember some of it fondly.
I think this one, right to Beatrice, I want to thank you for all the fashion advice you've given me, you know. Fast forward a few years, I'm going to be the next top model for a
for sure.
But yeah, no, thank you for talking with me all these weeks.
I just wanted to thank Iris so much, even though like it was really hard to like talk to each other due to like her speaking in the other language, I still felt I learnt so much about you and like from your past, and she could always like make a joke or make me smile, and like we could have like a good laugh with each other.
I just wanted to say a big thank you to Dennis, because I really enjoyed the program and I feel like I was really lucky to be talking to Dennis. And I just wish all the best for the future and great health.
Me and Kira wanted to say something about Jeanette because we both worked with her as well.
So I should say thank you for always telling us your stories about your traveling.
Yeah.
And always telling us to enjoy life and go and see the world and always be fearless in what you want to do.
I would like to say thank you to Graham for all the small chats we had, the wonderful talk about his horses and his family. He just loved talking about people and always loved to join me in no matter how hard I tried to get out of activities. Thank you.
That's a wrap.
Yay.
Singing before?
Sweet Caroline.
Give us another rendition.
Oh, I can't sing. I'm just humming like I do when you walk down the street. Sweet Caroline.
Siento que de hombre, how are you, mate?
How are you, mate?
Yo creí que era un perrito que había aquí.
She thought it was a dog.
Pero mira qué bonito. I don't have to tell her much, I just remind her a few things that she's forgotten, that's all, but she's been very, very good.
It's been very great talking to you, Kay.
Yep, now I'll give you that money I owe. You're beautiful.